IVM.
Hi.
You're
listening
to
IVM
Daily.
Hello and welcome to a brand new episode of IVM Daily. I'm in the studio with my friend Surbhi.
Woohoo! I'm your friend now.
My co-worker, colleague,
fine.
Strictly professional. And my name is Abbas. So today is a Tuesday and... okay, so today morning as I was leaving for office, I was browsing through the channels and the Golden Globes were happening.
Mm-hmm.
And I was seeing some amazing people who were being awarded for the stuff they did.
Yep.
Right? And
Andy Samberg.
Who, I don't know if he won anything, but he was
hosting.
I just want to say his name.
I want to just say
Lupita Nyong'o looked fabulous on the red carpet. Do check out her interviews. And but coming back to what I was saying is that it watching people get awards kind of made me look back at times that I have won some kind of award.
Oh no.
And I thought I would talk about it today on Daily with you, Surbhi. So were you someone in your school or college who was awarded a lot?
I won't say that I was awarded a lot, but I think whatever took part in a kind of
won something?
Yeah, but like out of like, no, I had no idea that I'll win something.
Okay.
Like one time I was in a dance competition and this was my first award of all times when I shit my pants. When like, so basically...
After winning the award?
After winning the award, because
okay.
I had no idea I'll do it. Because it was a dance competition and the whole idea was folk songs pe dance karna.
Okay.
So I danced on this song called Pairo Mein Bandhane.
Oh yes, I remember
yeah,
that song.
Sab Darwazi Kar Lo Band, that song.
The folk song?
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't know. It was a folk song. And then we used to, like, our principal would announce all the winners during the assembly. So, every person in the school would know.
Okay.
And so she said, the first prize goes to ne 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 ne. Second prize goes to ne 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 ne. Third prize goes to Surbhi. I was ecstatic. I could not believe, and everybody around me was... That was the first time I won an award, and I still remember that feeling.
What standard were you in?
I was in fifth standard.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
But didn't you feel happy and proud going
in? I was happy, but I was like, this is...
Did you have to go and take the award?
Yeah, you go up on stage and they give you a certificate.
Yeah.
And that was just it. But that feeling of everybody looking around and like looking for who Surbhi Bhaga is was so cool. I've never...
What was the trophy? Just a certificate?
It was a certificate.
Okay.
It just said, hey, Western folk dance competition, third prize goes to Surbhi. I was so happy.
Nice.
What about you?
My first prize or award, whatever, I remember was I won an essay writing competition.
Man,
in like 6th or 7th
standard.
You
were a nerd back then and also
and,
now.
Yeah. And so I think I won 2nd place and the trophy was actually a book. It was Goosebumps and the certificate was plastered onto the cover page of the book. So yeah, I was very excited to win it. But then a friend of mine borrowed the book and it never returned it.
Oh no.
So my first ever certificate is still somewhere with her.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Oh shit, dude. But what was the essay about?
The best day of my life.
Was it winning the award?
No, I made up some insane shit. I don't remember. Like I was...
aliens attacking.
No, it's a very nerdy essay only. Like I got selected for something and yeah, it was like my favorite sweet shop was open.
and then you woke up and it was a dream. I remember that part where like a lot of our essays would end with and then I woke up.
Twist
ending like M. Night Shyamalan. But I remember, so okay, so that's your first award.
Yeah.
My second award was in a debate competition.
Okay.
And that was also, I feel like, so I do this thing since the bachpan. Like every time I take part in a competition, the minute I'm like it's done, I stop thinking about who is to win.
Okay.
It's like helps me, like I feel like if I think about it too much, I'll jinx it. And
but
then
don't
it
you have it in the back
me.
Of your head? Like,
yeah.
I hope I win.
I tell myself, no, not even the back of my head. So we stop it. Think about other stuff. And then suddenly it happens. So I think my second award was in a debate competition. I'm forgetting what the topic was, but I think it was about, should we respect Mother Nature? Or should we? I think, I don't know, something on the, like it was on around Mother Nature and are we really polluting and something. And I was, so I won that award. Yeah.
Nice. But were you for it or against it?
I think I was for it. We should definitely protect Mother Nature.
Then I think I became a part of the school choir. And then our choirs would go to other inter-school competitions. Like, it was Pitch Perfect, the movie Pitch Perfect. But with like group choir singing.
Man, I didn't know you sing.
I did. I used
carols.
To. Carols and
sing what?
Other. No, not on air.
Do you know Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer?
Yeah.
Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. Had a very shiny. Man, you're good.
I'm good. I had one solo as well.
Of course you never told me about this.
Yeah. It's better left outside.
You have a solo?
I got a solo in one of the years. I sang Shepherd Boy.
Man.
The carol, yeah.
That's amazing.
So, but yeah, but then our choir used to win a couple of awards. I don't think we ever came first, but we were usually second or third.
Yeah.
So, winning it with a group was actually kind of pretty awesome.
What was an award that you always wanted, but like year after year, you just did not get it?
It's a speech, not speech writing, like elocution. Elocution always evaded me. And I think that's part of why I do stand-up comedy, because I'm like, I still want to prove to myself that I'm good at this.
Oh.
I'm good at speaking
if
to an audience.
That's what it means. You know what award I've always yearned in my life?
Which one?
Is the award for doing something in any sports thing.
Yeah.
I've always wanted to do something. And I remember, so like we'd have March past, you know, for around January 26th. Ah, yeah, this is the time where my school is practicing the March past. And so every year, some house would win this thing. But every year, my house would never win it. And I was in different houses throughout my school, okay? I was in a green
you
house, and
jinx.
I was in a blue house. And I would never win. For 5 years in a row, our whole group never won. And it was so embarrassing. Because maybe it was me. I don't think my hand-eye coordination is very good.
It was good, maybe. I was never athletic growing up. Like you said, I was a nerd, so I didn't even go there. I'm like, I don't even get that.
I've never won a sports award.
But another memory that sticks out is that I was assigned class monitor in 9th standard, and that happened, like you said, in an assembly where my name was called out, and I was given a badge.
Same.
Monitor badge to wear.
I was a class monitor pehle, but like growing up around 10th is when I was like, I felt like I was the king of the world.
Okay.
Because they made me the monitor of my whole house, which is a greenhouse monitor. It's called house leader.
House captain.
Yeah. House captain. And I had a badge called greenhouse house captain, and I would check for very trivial things like, oh, do you have carter in your eyes? And is your skirt
Yeah, the house captains were the worst. Dude. They're like, your shoes are not untied. And then you take out all their personal vendettas. Someone who didn't give them notes. They're like, isko bahar nikalo, like all that shit.
Dude, one time I discovered someone. So like, Mehendi was obviously not like in our school. One time I discovered like a full on racket of Mehendi. I'm not kidding, I was so good at this. I busted this racket. So I noticed a lot of times people would like get Mehendi, and suddenly the next day the arms are broken. They would have a plaster.
That's
or like they
clever.
Would, yeah, they would cover their hands and be like, I'm sorry, I fell. Like, you were at that wedding. I saw that photo on Facebook. And so I busted this racket, and like a friend also, I did not like her very much. So I was like, I looked at her keenly. I was like, I paid attention to her. And one time I saw her in the loo, and then she was washing her hands, and then I saw like a glimpse of Mehendi from beneath her plaster.
And
I was like
busted.
Got you red Mehendi handed. Got you green handed, bitch. But so like I did not tell her, but I was like, spoke to like my teacher. I was like, excuse me, miss, I would like to report an incident.
I got this lowdown on a racket that's happening in a shady lane somewhere. You meet your teacher, like, nice.
God, yeah. So that was busted, and then she had to. So did it happen in your school?
The calling people out. Yeah, Mehendi thing also, was not allowed. But
allowed.
Like after a point, there were girls who didn't give a shit. They would wear Mehendi anyways. They'd be like, teachers would be like, how much will I punish this? Just let it go.
It's weird why I don't feel like putting Mehendi now, because I was a big fan in school.
Because
like,
it was forbidden. When it's forbidden.
When it's forbidden, just like sex. No, don't feel
I didn't
like
win
it.
Any awards for that, but let's not go there.
Okay, college. College awards? Wow.
None? I can't think of anything. Yeah.
I think college was when I really boomed.
Really?
Like, that was my peak.
Wow. I think I fell from grace in college.
The grace of God, you fell into the lap of Satan.
Yeah.
And now you're doing comedy. But I think college was my, it was a good space. Because I was also, because I started my own committee. Dude, I was so outgoing.
What committee was this?
Yeah, so we had a Western music committee. Because I was really into Western music, like Hannah Montana.
Oh, when you say Western music, I'm thinking of Mozart and Beethoven and stuff.
No.
Okay.
I was into Hannah Montana and Jonas Brothers. And I would show off so much. I'm like, oh, yeah, have you heard this new single by Jonas? By Taylor Swift. And then Max, I would say Celine Dion.
Oh, okay.
Max, I don't go past that. Mm. And then first year,
how many members were there in your committee?
Dude, a lot. A lot of people signed up. Because the poster I made was super nice. It was like, do you like Western music? Like Miley Cyrus? People were into it. So they came down.
What would you do?
So basically, first I had auditions for people like who can actually sing and play.
Okay,
so you can play.
You actually had shows and stuff.
Yeah, we had shows. Okay. I was running that, man. I was running it, and we also had merchandise for West Music Committee. It was amazing. You also had a treasurer. So every committee would have like a president.
Whipping
a treasurer.
Money for this?
Yeah.
Shit.
Okay, so I had auditions where I would literally sit down, like, you know how
Indian Idol.
Yeah, like Indian Idol. Like I'd be like Anu Malik. There'll be another person.
But what gave you, because it was your committee, like I
It was
judged.
My committee. And nobody, also because I won. Oh yeah, I completely missed that point where before I started this whole thing, we had a freshers party.
Okay.
And during the freshers party, we were all supposed to perform something. And me and my friend sang a very nice song by Miley Cyrus. It's called The Climb.
Okay. Oh, so I've heard that song. Yeah.
It's the climb. Yeah. Oh man, we should jam on it. Now that I know that you're in a choir, we should probably sing it. But we won that, and we won hearts, and we won awards. So post that, I was like, you know what, let's leverage this. And I started my whole committee, and people came to audition. And then I had a whole group of people who would just sing. And we also attempted the cup song.
Anna Kendrick.
Yeah, we did a bunch of cool stuff. And then,
had a happening college life.
Man, you know me.
See, a podcast coming.
But my college life. What about later? I mean, in real life.
In real life awards?
I mean, like, post-college, you've never won an award? Like, for a...
For what?
A luck. Okay. Maybe it's like a reality show.
No, I wasn't on any reality show. My claim to fame is 12 seconds on Comic Stan season 1. That's about it.
Guys, you can watch me on Netflix.
Hey, this whole show was building up to this, guys. The idea for this.
It was actually totally your idea. But I'm so glad we did this. I feel great about myself.
But go ahead, plug your show.
No, you can watch me on Netflix. It's called Queens of Comedy. And
yeah, she didn't win the thing, but she's on it quite a bit.
What do you mean I didn't win it?
You were third?
I was in the top 3.
Oh, okay. You got the certificate of also, third place again.
A lot of awards, like appreciation.
That's true, yeah. And a job here.
And a job here. Yeah, that's how I made it to IVM Daily. A reality show.
So this is like on the episode of Where Are They Now, it would cut to you producing a podcast. This is what happened to Surbhi Bhaga, guys.
It's not such a bad thing.
Yeah. Talking of Queens of Comedy, you should check out the episode of Artha Lab, which has Nivedita Prakasam.
Yeah.
Who won the show.
This was the recent episode. With
It's streaming now on our website. So check it out.
Check it out.
Alright, so speaking of checking out our shows, you can also reach out to us on social media. You
what?
Can Segue.
Speaking of checking out, you should also reach out.
Yeah, you can talk to us. You can reach out to us on at IVM Podcast. We are on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram with that ID at IVM Podcast. You can follow me on Twitter. I am at Abbas Momin, and Surbhi.
I am at Small Talk Police on Twitter and at Surbhi.Bhaga on Instagram.
Yeah, every follow is an award for us.
That
so
is true.
Please do that. Please
follow me.
And we'll see you on another episode of IVM Daily very
soon.
And
remember to not put mehndi.
Yeah, if you're in school. All right.
Bye. Bye-bye.
Look, up in the internet. It's a meme. No, it's a cat video. No, it's the Geek Fruit Podcast.
That's right. We interrupt this riveting broadcast to tell you about our show, the Geek Fruit Podcast, where Tejas, Dinkar and I, Jishnu, talk about everything in pop culture, including DC, Marvel, Star Wars, Netflix and everything in between.
You know how your friends hate it when you ramble about some nerdy crap and you just want somebody to listen to you? Well, sorry, there's nothing we can do about that, but come listen to us ramble and it'll almost be like the real thing. Kind of.
Listen to new episodes of the Geek Fruit Podcast every Monday and the Geek Fruit Bulletin every Thursday on iTunes, Google Podcasts, the IVM app, or wherever you listen to podcasts. Happy listening, you nerds.
Every week comes a show where three people come together to tell you about stuff they like. A movie, a TV show, a book, and other stuff. Tune in every Monday on the IVM Podcast app to IVM Likes. Batman approves this message. Thank you, Batman.